every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Grace and peace from God our Father. Welcome to Fresh Start. This is Pastor Daryl Fair, and I am excited to begin a brand new day with each and every one of you. I'm particularly excited because we are in a week without worry, and we are building our faith based upon the Word of God to have a week without worry. Welcome to Fresh Start. This is our time of fellowship. It's our time of focusing our thoughts, and it's our time to build our faith based upon the Word of God. Lamentations chapter number 3 and verse 23 says that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is His faithfulness to you and I. And so we're thankful and we're grateful that God has blessed us with a brand new day, and indeed He has given us a fresh start. Let's go back to Philippians chapter number 4, verse number 6. Once again, be anxious for nothing. Do not be anxious about anything. We're using this as the backdrop of having a week without worry. Put it in the chat one more time. You can do hashtag WWW. You can do, well, don't do hashtag. Don't do hashtag. Don't do hashtag. I just thought about something about algorithms. So just put in there hashtag week without worry. Hashtag week without worry. We want to have that. And the only way we can do that is we got to work the principles that enable us to do that. Now, yesterday we gave one principle on how to have a week without worry. And that's number one, we've got to be able to monitor the things that make me worry. Got to monitor the things that make me worry. Now, one of the other things we've got to be able to do in having a week without worry, write this down. Here's number two. We've got to be willing to do, catch this, what seems impossible. We have to be willing to do what seems to be impossible. Be willing to do the things that seem impossible. Now, I've heard people say that the phrase be not afraid is mentioned 365 times in the Bible. I've heard that. I don't know if you've ever heard that before. But when I did the research, it's not written 365 times, because people were saying, you know, God wrote in His Word, don't be afraid, 365 times in the Word of God. So you can read it, you know, take one of them every single day of the year. And so it sounded good, but I did my research. It's not. And it's written several times, multiple times in Scripture for multiple reasons. But it's not quite the 365. I don't even think it's 300. The point I'm making is, have you noticed that there are times in Scripture where God will ask people to do things that seem to be impossible? An angel shows up to Mary and says, don't be afraid. I've never seen an angel before. I don't have, you know, I've never had time with angels before. And you're telling me that the very first time I see one, I'm not to be afraid? And then there are times when we go through things and our faith is being challenged. And even in Scripture, where people went through things and their faith was being challenged, and God would give them a word to do the very opposite. There's a scripture in the New Testament where a widow, which means she lost her husband, is now burying her only son. The funeral procession is going on at that time. And Jesus sees it. Jesus is going into the city. They're coming out of the city. So they kind of cross paths. And the scripture says when Jesus notices what's going on, he puts his hand on what we call the casket, and he tells the mother, stop crying. Now, again, she's got every reason to cry. She's lost her husband. Now she's getting ready to bury her only son. And Jesus tells her, stop crying. There are times in scripture, again, where we are challenged in our faith, and people in the Bible were challenged in their faith, and God would give them something to do that seems impossible. How do you tell someone who's at a funeral not to cry when they're burying their son? Mark chapter number five, verse 35 and 36 is another case where the scripture says, while he yet spake, there came from the ruler of the synagogue's house certain which said, thy daughter is dead. Why trouble thou the master any further? Verse 36 says, as soon as Jesus heard the word that was spoken, he saith unto the ruler of the synagogue, be not afraid, only believe. Now, let me do this as quickly as I can. This ruler of the synagogue tracked down Jesus because his daughter was at death's door. She was very, very ill. So Jesus goes he goes to find Jesus, hoping that Jesus would come and heal the daughter. Well, it's at the same time where Jesus is in a crowd and the woman who has the issue of blood touches his garment. He turns around, has a conversation with her. And while they're in the midst of having that conversation, someone from the ruler of the synagogue's house comes to him and says, don't even worry. Don't even tell Jesus to come to the house because your daughter is no longer sick. She is now dead. But Jesus heard what they said and turns to the father, the ruler of the synagogue, and says, don't doubt, only believe. When you are ready to have a week without worry, you have to be willing. We've got to be willing to do the things that seem on the surface to be impossible. How can I do this? How can I not worry? Because God says you and I can do all things through him that loved us. God willing, I'll see you tomorrow morning as we continue to have a week without worry. Be willing to do what seems impossible. God bless.
See?